Hello everyone, today we're going to be painting this wooden plane. So I'm going to be using a few colors. I'm going to be using orange and yellow, that's what I have planned right now. So yeah. And I'm going to be using a rag, this wooden thing of course. Some water. And paints. So first I'm gonna start painting, I guess. Or maybe I should sketch a design on it. That's fine. I don't need to. So I'm just gonna paint, I guess. It's always good to have a nice first coat. The truth is, you don't really need to prime wood to paint on it with acrylic paints. Maybe if you're using like fabric paints or something, you might need to prime it. I have never primed my wood before. It's worked just fine. Let's get some water. You can make your paint more voluminous by adding some water to it. Bright orange. I'm using this orange, is called neon orange. It's an acrylic paint by CraftSmart. Just gonna squirt it in here. Gonna take some water. Gonna mix it in with this. Okay, so we got that part done. I'm gonna take a smaller brush. This one. It doesn't have a number on it, so I can't really tell anyone the number. Take the orange paint from here. Put it on. I don't know these wooden parts over here. I'm just gonna paint this on the sides. And the other side. Already need more paint. My orange. I'm gonna take some water now. It's good to add water into your paint. Makes it more translucent. That was a lot of paint on my brush. Just add as much water as you want, as thin. It'll make the paint more thin, but it'll make the paint spread better. Forgot this part. Now we can paint the bottom. Have you ever painted wood? Leave a comment down below if you have. And tell me if you like it as well. I like it. It's fine if those streaky lines come because this is the bottom. No one's gonna be like, oh, how does the bottom look? If you don't like them, just keep on stroking till you get a desired result. See, that helps. Makes it less strokey. No one likes those thick strokes. I'm fine with the thin ones, but the thick ones, just, I don't like them. Okay, there. I think we should paint the top one more time. Let's use our big brush. Okay. Dry, so then we can maybe add another coat. Maybe just paint this part. Okay, so now we can put the brush in water. And let's start painting with yellow. I'm gonna wash this brush. Okay, now let's get some water and put it in the yellow. So I have my yellow here. It's called bright yellow. So I'm gonna start painting with it. This looks really weird already, but it's just fun to paint. Maybe it's like an emergency jet or something. If someone urgently needs to go to Hawaii for a vacation, they can just take this. People will think it's it. And then there'll be no online traffic because they'll think it's an emergency. Okay, just need to paint a little bit more. I forgot one more orange detail. Tiniest detail ever. We can paint the sides later for the yellow. Okay, so now we're gonna paint the sides. I'm gonna paint them yellow because this part's yellow. Let's take a little bit of water and add it into your yellow. A bead of yellow just fell down over here. This bead of... Okay, I need some more yellow paint. Then I'm gonna get some water. Add it to my paint. Again, it makes your paint more voluminous and translucent, so then you can spread it around way better. And it decreases the lifespan of one squirt of paint. So you can spread it way better on wood when you add water. And see, with only one dip, we almost covered more than half of the surface. Trying to flip it around. Okay, so now time for the other side. Just gonna paint it. For me, it's fine if the yellow gets on these parts because I think I'm gonna paint them black. With one dip, we covered this whole side. Now time for the bottom. Sure, I'm not gonna paint the bottom yet because it'll be bottom will be resting on that part, and we don't want paint on our surface. Okay, so let me get my black. So I have this black from CraftSmart. It's literally called black. Okay, so I'm gonna get on my small brush over here. Put some water. Put it in the black. Don't think I need it to make the black translucent, though. Just gonna paint the propellers, or let's call them fans, black. Just gonna paint them black. Kind of looks good black. This is getting super wobbly. Okay, we'll work on the sides later. Just need to do the other propeller. I'm gonna work on the sides when it's completely dry, so you guys might not see me working on the sides. Okay, let's flip the plane over. And let's paint these black. Okay, so we need to continue painting it black on the side here. If you do quick strokes like this, you can get more paint on there, then you won't have to dip that much. Let's get the sides. Okay, so now this side. Okay, so I think I made the colors a little too flashy, but it's fine, it still works. I need to paint the wheel black too, but there's nothing dry red yet. I really don't know how to pick this up. Let's try fixing this up. Hold it like this, then paint the wheel black. Just not gonna paint the bottom. Okay. So got the wheel almost completely black. Now the other side. So the plane is now done. Thanks for watching, and like this video if you think the plane looks good. Give a thumbs down if you don't like it. Bye!